Hi everyone, welcome back to A Great Books. I'm Ellie and today I am doing my favourite things of 2017 that aren't books. So I think I discovered quite a few new things in 2017, but I decided to narrow it down, I guess. I've picked one movie, one TV show, one music artist, I guess, and then just another one that I guess is kind of a given. Let's just start with movie. I think this is, I mean, I was tossing up between two, but I think I have to go with this one because I guess it's kind of, it is my favourite movie of the year. That is Wonder Woman. This surprised me because I'm not a DC girl, I guess. I like Batgirl. Batgirl is actually my favourite superhero. But other than Batgirl, I don't really like any DC characters. Definitely more of a Marvel fan, and that's because I love Captain America. And I also really love Agent Carter. So yeah, I was kind of surprised by how much I loved it, and I had issues with it. I don't think it's perfect, but it was, I can't put it into words just like how amazing it felt to walk out of that cinema having seen something so, like, if, I don't know how to put it, it kind of felt like a movie for feminists and for young girls without necessarily being about that. So yes, I really like that, and I'm struggling to put into words how that book made me feel, just like seeing young girls walking around with like Wonder Woman things and seeing Wonder Woman merch available. Because if you think about it, there isn't really any other superhero, like, girl stuff. I've seen, like, I own quite a few, like, Captain America shirts and other Marvel things. But yeah, I own, like, before this, I owned, like, one set of Batgirl pajamas that I bought in the UK. And it's just so great to see young girls be able to have like a superhero. Yeah, so that's that. TV. When I tried to think of my favourite TV show of this year, the one that like instantly sprung to mind was a show called The OA. It is a Netflix original series. I think I talked about this in a TV video few months back, but this show absolutely blew my mind. It was incredible. It was recommended to me by my friend Sarah, and when she was sort of like, I guess, like pitching it to me, I wasn't like super interested in it. She was talking about there was this girl who went missing as a child and comes back, and before she left, she was blind, and she comes back and she can see, and I just, that didn't really intrigue me because it felt just, you know, the usual disability erasure. But I watched it and it was actually incredible. It is incredibly hard to describe. It's kind of like a sci-fi-ish kind of thing. I don't really know. It's got Jason Isaacs in it, who plays Lucius Malfoy in the Harry Potter films. He's one of my favourite actors, even though, like, I don't like Lucius Malfoy, but I respect him for the role that he played. And yeah, it's just so weird and just beautiful. It's only 10 episodes. hopefully there's going to be another season, because I just can't with that ending. I just can't. So I hope there is more. And yeah, that's, I highly recommend that. Not a lot of people I know have seen it or just don't talk about it, but it's really good. It is weird, like you have to stick with it. It's incredibly well written, but yeah, it's just very strange, and I think that might put people off, but if you stick with it, it is totally worth it. Yes. Music. I know that, like, for some people, like, I don't know, they'll have, like, new artists that they love, or, like, brand new songs. Not me. I've gone back in time. And the artist that really defined 2017 for me was actually David Bowie. I hadn't really listened to any Bowie. Like, I listened to a lot of old music growing up that my parents loved. I say old music, so like 70s, 80s. So like, I love Fleetwood Mac, and I love Queen, and I love Bruce Springsteen, and those sorts of people. But neither of my parents were Bowie fans. And last year I watched Labyrinth for the first time. I mean 2016. I watched Labyrinth for the first time and completely fell in love with David Bowie. And then just throughout 2017, I've just consistently, I think I've like listened to at least one David Bowie song like almost every day this year. It's an obsession. I have a little Bowie keyring on my keys. I have several Bowie shirts now, and I just love him. I think his music is incredible. Again, it's weird as hell, but I like it, and I really like him as a person. I watched a lot of his old interviews, and he's really, really intelligent and well put together, and I really appreciate that. So I kind of like vaguely knew about David Bowie. I guess he really came under my radar when he passed away, which sadly is sort of the thing that happens with lots of artists. But yeah, I love him now, and his music just makes me really happy. And yeah, so David Bowie is my 2017, basically. And then finally, the last thing I wanted, this is like my given one that I was talking about, and that is of course my cat Percy. I'm not gonna try and like bring him into the video because I'm wearing shorts and a sleeveless top and cats and claws, just, that's not a good idea. So I have like millions of pictures of him, so I'm gonna put a few up here. And I adopted him May 28th this year. May 28th is a rough day for me. May is a rough month. Here in Australia, it's Mother's Day, and it's also my late mother's birthday on the 28th of May. So to get Percy on that day really meant something special. And it kind of, it's like I have a good memory on that day now. So yeah, that was good, and I love him. He's adorable. He is the sweetest cat I have ever met. And I just love him very much. And having, I don't know if anyone else that deals with mental health issues and chronic illness or disability in any way, shape or form feels the same as this, but sometimes having him to look after makes looking after myself easier. It's like I forget to look after myself a lot, and to have him there that I have to like feed and drink
feed and, I don't know, like, give water. There we go. I have to feed and water him and play with him and that sort of stuff. Yeah, it makes it easier to remember to, like, feed myself and that I need to go out and go for a walk sometimes to clean my head and that sort of thing. So not only does he give the best cuddles, he also reminds me to look after myself. So yes, Percy is definitely, I'm gonna say, yeah, he's the best thing that's happened to me this year. So thank you, Percy. Anyway, that's it. That's my last video for 2017 wrap-up wise, I think. I just want to take this moment to thank everyone who watches my videos and supports me and all of my good friends that have been with me in 2017. I usually like to take, like, the end of the year to, like, send thank you messages and Christmas messages to my friends, and I didn't have the time this year. But please know that I really appreciate each and every one of you for your love and support, and I hope that 2018 is off to a good start for you. I know it is for me, so I hope that everyone else is doing well, and I will see you guys in a few days. I'm going to be talking about some 2018 books. I'll see you all then. Thanks for watching. Bye.